What is the advantage over conventional lifting points?
The all-new Root ACP is like its smaller predecessors, the first lifting point in the world that thinks for itself. An ingenious spring mechanism prevents the lift bale from being vertically positioned at an angle of 90 degrees from the side, the dangerous transverse or lateral load direction in practice. Conventional center pull hoist rings will not do this, and some manufacturers even prohibit this lifting position, although it is practical and avoidable. If a load is applied to the lift bale in the zero degree position, it usually stops at first. Key to success is an internal protected spring mechanism, which keeps the lift bale out of the hatched area.
What dangers can result from the zero-degree position?
If the tensile forces become higher, the lift bale may suddenly flip over and the load may sag in an uncontrolled manner. In the worst case, however, the lift bale does not fold over. Respectively, it does not align itself in the direction of pull, which means it remains in the aforementioned dangerous position. This generates high shear forces that can cause deformation or breakage of the bolt, which in turn can lead to a load drop. The all-new ACP foam rod avoids this dangerous and unpredictable side load position. But it allows, of course, to lift straight up in a single pick lift application.
In which sizes will the ACP now be launched on the market?
The ACP will now be launched in metric sizes M36 and M42, as well as in imperial sizes 1.5 and 1.75, with load capacities of up to 16 metric tons.
Are there other features that make the new ACP stand out?
The bolts are also available in various lengths, just like with other rod lifting points. In addition to the spring mechanism, the ACP has the proven rod combi head screw in a strength class 10.9. This allows the user to insert the lifting point by hand at the start of the assembly. Subsequently, the necessary torque can be applied with a wrench or by means of an Allen key. The permissible load capacity is shown in tons with a design factor of 4, as well. The specification in pounds shows the design factor of 5. Not to forget the required tightening torque. This means the ACP fulfills the requirements of ASME B30.26, which is particularly important in the US market.
How can the ACP be identified for mandatory testing?
For an easy identification and documentation process, RUD relies on the serially embedding of RFID transponders, the so-called RUD ID points. These small chips are used for an error-prone identification of many RUD components. Test certificates and other documentation can thus be retrieved in a user-friendly manner and at any time via the RUD portal or simply stored in a cloud online. A free space on the side of the lift bale creates the possibility for additional customer-specific markings. Common methods like stamping, needle embossing, or laser processes are possible here. Wear markings on the inner side of the suspension bale provide the user with a simple identification, for example, when the wear limit has been reached, thus simplifying the inspection process. All moving components are available as spare parts too.